In this video demonstration, we will implement high availability for server virtualization with Virtual Machine Manager. Okay, so let's begin by adding the host cluster to VMM. So we're going to add host. And from here, under computer name, I'm going to select NYC-HVCluster. We'll click add. And it says that it's a cluster, it's going to add all nodes. So we'll select next. We'll add them to all hosts. And we'll just next through the wizard. Okay, and with that we can see that the hosts have been added in from the cluster. So let's go ahead and create a highly available virtual machine. So we're going to use an existing virtual machine template. And I'm going to select the Cortex VHD. For the virtual machine name, I'm going to call this VMM-HA. For the hardware, we're just next. We're going to place it on a host, and we're going to select host 1. Okay, and it says we've selected a clustered host. We'll select the external network. Next on the additional properties. And we'll start the virtual machine after the task is completed. So we just wait for the job to complete. And we can see that that is now done. Okay, so let's test live migration. So from there we can see that NYC host 1 is the current host. Let's select NYC host 2. From here we can see that the virtual machine is moving across. And that it's now completed. From there, let's expand all hosts, let's click on our HV cluster, and let's go into our properties. Because what we want to do now is manage the host cluster. So on our networks, we're going to select external network. Under storage, we can see that we've got our VM cluster storage. So what I want to do is, I want to add some more storage. So I'm going to go back into server 4. I'm going to go into my iSCSI target, and under iSCSI targets, I'm going to create a new one. We'll just call this LUN2, so LUN-02, and we'll say next. Under the IQN identifier, we're going to select the first one for host 1. I'm then going to go in and this time select the second one for host 2. We'll select OK and OK, and from there we'll select next. We'll complete the wizard. And then under devices, let's go ahead and create a virtual hard disk. So we'll select next. For the file, let's point this to /disks/disk03.vhd. We'll select next. We'll type in a size of 12 gigs. And for the iSCSI targets, we're going to point this to LUN2. So we'll say finish. Okay, back into NYC host 1. From here, I'm going to go into my iSCSI initiator. Now do bear in mind, like before, this needs to be done on both machines. But in order to save time, I'm just doing it on one. So we're going to connect to the new path. And then back in to Server Manager, under Disk Management, we are going to turn the disk online. We're going to initialize the disk. And we're going to go ahead and create a new simple volume. So we use all available space. We don't want to assign a drive letter to this new volume. And from there, we're going to type in the volume label VM Storage 2. So with that done, let's go back into our failover cluster manager, into storage, and from there we're going to add a disk. We're going to add cluster disk 3, and we can see that that is now put into the cluster manager window. We're going to add storage to the clustered shared volumes, again picking cluster disk 3. And minimize our failover cluster. So if I go back into our virtual machine manager system, I'm going to refresh the highly available cluster, go into the properties, and if I click on storage, we can now see that we've got that second storage available to us.